Whoever's in your prayer.
All right.
Glory to your name. Keep on making a way for me. I don't think none of us gonna reject that, huh? Over and over again. He does so much. He will ever sing your praise. Glory to his name. Lord, keep on making a way for me. Yes, Nicholas, keep on making a way. I bless his name this morning. It's good to be back in the house of the Lord.
That's right.
Don't worry about the numbers. We miss our fellow saints, but the Lord is here.
Yeah.
So, in other words, I'm going to do what I'm going to do because I trust in who he is. I don't just do church. I trust him. I do Jesus.
You know what I mean?
So, as long as two people showed up, I guess I'd come to preach.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It ain't me. It's him. You know what I mean? I trust in him, and I'm going to do what he said to do.
Yeah.
But since I know it's more than two or three of us in here gathered,
right,
I know that he is here.
Right.
And his spirit has been forever faithful.
Yeah.
And I was thinking about what Reverend Patrick was talking about. He did all the stuff that's going on in the world and the wars in North Korea, the stuff in Charlottesville, the race. And it's like, it ain't going to get better for the folks in the world. That ain't going to happen. Oh, but it's going to get way better for us that are saved for the righteous. See, it ain't going to get better for them. And that's by design, because they're going to need to know, like you said, that God is God, and they're going to have a place to run to. And we're going to be the lights for them to run to. So it ain't going to get no better for them. But you ought to be grateful that you saved, and you ain't on the outside looking in to where you ain't got no hope and no God in this world. I bless his holy name for my salvation every day. Every day. I'm grateful for what I heard this morning and the testimonies. You know, just the Spirit is faithful. I thank him for carrying the saints over and giving them journeys, mercy. It's not a small thing. And I'm so grateful that, because the only one person, our God, omnipresent, that can be everywhere all the time looking after all of us in our life.
Amen.
And that's the only thing we can count on and depend on and hope in. And Lord, send your angel, send your spirit, send your word. And then you rest in that. Because can't nobody else do nothing. Nobody else. Let God be true and every man the only person. Hope thou in God. That's it.
Yeah.
If you can't hope in God, then he ain't what you got. Then he ain't hoping nothing else. So I thank you for that, that they would enjoy themselves. I know that Vision Mom and Ginger seen this much more to come.
Yeah.
Because it's a lot of places for us to go.
Yeah.
We got Africa. We got Jerusalem. It's a whole lot of places that the Lord going to carry us. And I'm going to be on board because I plan on living in this abundant life.
Right.
And so, the last time that I was up, that's what I was talking about, the path to the abundant life. And I'm so grateful with Mama Sally's testimony and Brother Jimmy's and all of it, and with Chrissy's, because there is a straight path for us to get there, but you have to be wanting to chase greatness and not be this in the comfort zone of being ordinary. You know what I mean? This is a challenge. You got to work for this. It just don't come easy. But if you just want to be saved, then you just sit on in the seat and come to church every Sunday. That might be for some people, but that ain't for me.
Right.
And I don't think how it could be for any of us that was brought up in here, the way that in the road that we come across and the things that we seen the Lord do, his mighty hand working in our lives. So I can't be content with being ordinary. It drives me crazy. You know what I mean? To just want to be ordinary and do ordinary things and just be saved. And I can't be around nobody that won't get it. I got to be around folks that want to be chasing greatness. You know, so I bless his name. If you would stand, we're going to read the word. I'm going to finish up this path to the abundant life, which is basically going to be the bottom two scriptures there. John 7:37 says, in the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spoke he of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. Matthew 5:6, blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. And to go up one more verse for that, the thief comes not but to steal and to kill and to destroy, but I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Amen. If you bow your heads with me. Lord God, we bless your name this morning. I thank you myself for another opportunity to speak before your people. We touch and agree that your word come forth, that revelation comes forth, that is unhindered, unstopped by any demonic force or spirit. We ask that it work, that it deliver it free, comfort, and strengthen us. In the name of Jesus, none of me and all of you, Father. And all your people said,
amen.
I want to also still be mindful of the prayer request in the Smith family. That's a tragic loss. That's only the comforter can comfort them. I'm going to keep them in prayer.
Amen.
I thank the Lord for calling us out of darkness.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
And I want to be mindful that it might be somebody, some of us in here today that's in need of a healing virtue. I'm here to let you know by the Lord's stripes you are healed.
Yeah.
They might be somebody in here today in need of some comfort, some peace, some strength, some truth and deliverance. We cast our cares upon our Lord because he cares for us. I ask that he sends his comforter and the Prince of Peace. The word says that he will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts you. Lord, help our minds to be stayed on you. We can't forget to leave that out. And that we trust you.
Right.
Then you will keep us in perfect peace if we do what we're supposed to do. So I ask you, Father, that you bind up every sickness and disease, any other attack from the enemies right now in the name of Jesus. We loose your healing power. We loose deliverance in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
I'm serious about tasting this greatness, saints. And I hope that you are too. If you ain't, hopefully somewhere along this journey, the love of God might inspire you to see this and want to chase it. But that's what this path to the abundant life is all about. It's about chasing greatness. And that is in God. Bottom line. And just to recap what I went over before, I started off talking about this path where it first began for us was, it was birthed in the love of God and it always will be. In the very beginning when he said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. That was God pouring into us his best of the entire Godhead, which is his spirit. That's our prized possession, that he poured his best into us, because that ain't in the flesh. Because don't no good thing dwell in the flesh. So our prized possession is what God poured into us. Let us make man in our image after our likeness. You know, then he said, then he blessed us. He said, be fruitful, multiply, subdue the earth, have dominion or rule over what I've given you. Then came the fall by lies and disobedience. But then came the love of God again, with redemption, with forgiveness, with reconciliation, and with our salvation from the cross of Christ. Love always coming back around to get us. Then I moved on talking about that I might know him, and in the power of his resurrection, and in the fellowship of his sufferings. See, we can never leave out suffering, saints, because the Lord suffered. And we buried with him by baptism into that suffering, into that death. And we know that suffering expedites progress, and it causes change. We got to accept it. Like Patrick was saying, so therefore, the word says, endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. We got to man up and suck it up sometimes. Right. Two things we know in this journey. We in a fight, as Brother Jimmy said, but it's the good fight of faith. We're in a fight, but it's a good fight. Why? Because Jesus has already overcome the world, and we got the victory through faith. That's why it's a good fight. You know what I mean? You know, you like a good fight where, you know, you got the victory. That's a good fight. And we know that we are at war. But it says, but the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. That's where our mentality has to be, that our weapons are mighty to pull down any and everything by the casting down of imaginations, every high thought that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing to every captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Your mind will run rampant, so you have to bring those thoughts into captivity to the obedience of Christ. It's like you said, Mama, you'll go crazy. You drive yourself crazy.